έλα, έλα, πάρε με. Άνοιξε τσι δυο σου αγκάλες, μέσα βάλε με. Instrument you are playing here.
This is a new instrument on the market. This is my own design, my own instrument, and it's called Gagava. It's a sound that comes from years before. That was the reason that I did it. I wanted to go back a few hundreds of years, and I think I did it. I think I did it. I think that I reached that point. It's not a lute, it's not like the Bouzouki. Does not belong to the lute family. I made it with a back also, vibrating back as the soundboard. There is a lot of way to go ahead, go farther down. It's not finished yet all the way. The shape of course is there, everything is there, but there are a lot of details that have to be done, have to be changed. Many things have to be changed as far as the bracing, the sides and everything else. I think that little by little I will get there.
Yes, for sure, but it's still in developmental mm-hmm. stage, yeah, mm-hmm. so. Step by step, it will reach its final shape and sound.
The shape, I will stay with the shape of the boat. Okay. That is why I named it Gagava. Gagava is an old fishing boat.
Yes.
Does not exist anymore. It was a boat that was not fishing fish, but corals and sponges.
Ah, okay.
With the net was not from nylon material. It was from rope. It was from steel nets.
Steel nets?
Steel nets. Mm-hmm. So they can scrape the bottom of the sea.
But the water, like, but they were heavy nets then, huh?
Huh?
They were heavy.
Very,
the nets.
Very heavy. And the boat was very slow.
Okay.
Because of all that stress that they had to go through.
But the sound of the Gagava is not slow.
No. The sound of the Gagava is not slow.
How would you describe the sound of the Gagava?
Well, it is an Eastern sound, but divided the Western way. It is an Eastern sound. It sounds more like an old zither or the old lutes and the and the woods that they had years ago. And the sustain on it also is wonderful. Mm-hmm. It needs a little bit more of improvement. So you can have a whole meter with only one strike. You understand what I mean? Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can keep a tenuta, as we call it.
You can keep it what?
A tenut. You can keep as long as you wish.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. At least for one whole meter, you can keep the sound of it. Yeah. So you can be, you can say that, okay, I have a classical instrument in here. I don't have to go up and down with the platform all the time in order to reach that.
To keep the volume.
That time, to keep the volume.
So, and now you are expecting all the people from all over the world to come to your shop and to buy the instrument in large quantities.
I don't expect all the world. But a few.
Okay.
Of course. Now, I expect people that they do have some, how you say it, something in their mind, some aesthetic or orientation,
yes.
Let's call it like that. They do want something that is different. They are seeking for it. People of art, in other words.
Yes.
Not Bouzouki players. People that they want to try something different. And I believe that this is a new field for many, many people. It's a new sound, you can put it wherever you want.
Yeah.
In any kind of music.
Maybe you can give a little example with the instrument and your voice, the singing.
Yeah.
What about the psarrades?
Yeah, why not? Έχετε ψαράδες ψάρια, αστακούς και καλαμάρια, αστακούς και καλαμάρια.
Thank you very much, Yanni. And from my side, I wish you lots and lots of success with the new instrument.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And that many, many people all over the world, let's say all over the world, will start to play on this instrument.
Hopefully, they will. It is a nice instrument. It fits everywhere.
Yeah,
in every music, you can use it.
Υπότιτλοι AUTHORWAVE.